I beg your pardon, Shueisha. If you guys haven't heard, is that One Punch Man is obviously getting its second season, which is a big hooray for all of us One Punch Man fans. But it's not getting animated by Madhouse like it was on season one. Now, of course, there is going to be a lot of doubt because obviously Madhouse is, it's the animation god studio that everybody loves. Everybody wants everything animated by Madhouse because of their track record. Bear in mind, like back in the day, they actually went bankrupt. And anyway, it doesn't really matter. Madhouse is very good with their staff and they're very good animation wise and they have a very good track record. It's very unlikely that you would see an anime come from them that looks like shit, hence why the reputation that it has. Now, of course, because of Madhouse's reputation, the fact that season 2 of One Punch Man, which I don't know why, they would change studios. I don't know whose idea this was, whether it was Shueisha's production committee or Madhouse themselves, I'm not quite sure, or whether JC staff literally said, hey, let us do it please, we'll fucking like do it for like half the price. I don't know. But yeah, JC staff are the ones that are going to be animating One Punch Man, and is this a bad thing? Well, honestly, to be upfront with you, it's not exactly a bad thing, but rather an interesting one to say the least, because where Madhouse has this amazing reputation and it's shown us what One Punch Man can look like with this Madhouse budget, especially with the, you know, Saitama versus Genos fight, the Saitama versus Boros, a lot of the Saitama fights in general, just how beautifully looking these fights were, can a series such as can a studio such as JC staff, who have done, from the top of my head, obviously Shokugeki no Soma, and Is It Wrong to Pick Up Girls in the Dungeon, are the first two that just pop into my mind, so don't worry about if I got anything wrong, there's loads more. But from those two, and I mean JC staff have never given, from what I've seen anyway, a bad track record. They do good animation, they do good anime, you know, especially Shokugeki no Soma, they do some really good shit, especially some high detailed artwork when it comes to food. So I feel like they can do it, and the attacks and the fight scenes in Is It Wrong to Pick Up Girls in a Dungeon were pretty good too. Can it be Madhouse? And can it be, or is it going to be too different? Like, is the difference between season 1 and season 2, are they going to be really apparent? And I say that because we have an example such as Terraformars, right? Season 1, it was done by IG, and then I don't know who did the second season, or if it was just a different team in general, but the differences between the both artistically and animation wise, it was just uncanny that these two series were just completely different. And that's the problem, is that when people are gonna, especially with One Punch Man's big massive following and how much, you know, people really got into the casuals, especially we really went mainstream, that are they gonna be disappointed by this? Are they gonna notice the difference? And it just goes on with that. Is it gonna be able to carry on that hype that Madhouse left it and its direction? Because obviously the director and the new staff are obviously doing season 2, so is it gonna have, well, of course it's not gonna have that same flair, but is it gonna do better or is it gonna do worse? And I feel like because of Madhouse's just tier that they've already put on for season 1 and how much everybody loved that, I feel like JC staff are really going to need to do everything they possibly can to make season 2 just as good. And I feel like that's not gonna be the case. But we have some hype stuff that's going to be adapted in season 2. So can the story, just like Berserk, and I'm not using Berserk as a fucking example, trust me, I'm not. But the only reason why I watched Berserk in a 3D format was because the story was just that goddamn good. So can One Punch Man's story and the adaptation of that story overweigh the kind of mindset of looking at an animation? Hopefully so, if you get what I mean. Like, would you enjoy the story so much that you don't even think about the difference in animation or the difference or direction and stuff like that? Just a little thing to pick your brain. But hopefully One Punch Man season 2 is going to be adapting some really cool content. I can't wait to see that content get done, and as long as it just gets done right, and as long as it just keeps that One Punch Man over the top dramatic explosions and just raw fucking hype, then I've got no issues with this. But JC staff, please don't disappoint me. I'm giving you a benefit of the doubt here, because most of the series that you've done that I've watched have been pretty good and pretty decently animated. So you know, this is where you're going to be put on the spotlight, unfortunately. So I am going to leave it off with that, guys. Tell me your guys' thoughts, of course, in the comment section down below of what you think of this overall season 2 change of studio. But yeah, with that being said, you guys, of course, have this fine day. Been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.